All right, guys, it's been a while. You will get the Project Files for free. Today, we're going to make a Drake and 21 Savage track similar to the tracks off of Her Loss. So it kind of centers around like the R&B vibe, the sample vibe, and kind of a technique I'm going to show you, which is like smearing a sample. Okay, so I'm going to grab a sample from waves.com. It's called, it's Gabe Lucas, Love You Forever. First step is map the BPM to match the actual sample. So it says 90. Let's make this 90, just drag it in, line it up to the grid, and just double check that the metronome hits. At the same time, go to song mode. See how it doesn't line up perfectly? Mostly because there's a little gap in the beginning, so grab your slip tool, hit Alt, and then left click and drag it until the audio is lined up. Okay, so with these pre-made loops, sometimes they know how to line stuff up, sometimes it's off. Okay, we only need 8 bars of this, we don't need the entire loop. Let's slice it right at the 8 bar mark, hit shift to do a vertical slice, and then just right click, get rid of the rest. So now let's just focus on this, let's make this unique so that we don't grab the rest of the song. Save it, okay. Okay, now we're gonna double click the sample, right click, open in Fruity Slicer. This is going to give you the 21 Savage type sound. Go to your slice tool, go to beat. Again, you will get the project files. Just go to busyworksbeats.com/FL Studio. That's how you get these for free. Turn this time stretch knob up. Okay, so it stretches per slice now. Okay, and then you can also mess with the pitch. Since it's already pitched up, we don't need to mess with it. Okay, let's go to pattern. Let's drag this in and it will map it per our slice. So let's go to song mode. See how it's a different vibe? You don't have to stretch it that much. If your clicks, pull up your attack. Now the sample already has reverb, so we don't have to overly process the reverb. Also, you're gonna hear my analog chain. Once we make the beat, I'm gonna run it through some analog to show you how big you can make very minimalistic stuff using Sonics. Okay, now that we have that, again, you will get the project files for free. So don't worry about like memorizing every single step. Next, let's grab our hi-hats to start that bass rhythm, B-A-S-E rhythm, okay? Let's go to closed hi-hats. It's like this hi-hat, it just works, okay? Let's add one randomly over here and then right click, fill each two steps so that it fills the entire. So I forgot we're at 90 BPM. Let us move the BPM now to. See how now the sample sounds weird because we're speeding it up. So we're gonna pull the time stretch harder. Now, if you want to keep it in line, you can go double the BPM, so it's 180, but we're not gonna make a 180 beat. Let's make it. So somebody asked, like, you know, what BPM is the perfect one? You just, what do you hear in your head, and how fast is it? I mean, that's my answer to you. And do you hear rappers on it? So 140 is working for this vibe because of the sounds. Let's hit Control L, send that to the mixer. Okay, so now let's mess with the pitch just to show you. I'm going to pull this down 300 cents. Now you can go in the pattern and actually change up the pattern. So if you don't like the way it's mapping out, that was kind of dope. I like that. So I'm going to make our own custom rhythm. Okay, it's because I like the way the pattern is. And then we're gonna repeat it and then have it do a different change up. I'm hitting Control to highlight and Shift left click to drag those notes over. Okay, let's copy this over, and I'm just going to change the endings. So this really gives you control over the melodic portion to the sample. Don't want to go like da da. I need like da da da. There we go. Okay, so now we have a bounce. So once you have that, now we can go back to the drums. Just ask, do you want a clap or a snare? Probably clap. Let's add a little bounce there. Let's go to pattern three. Make sure you're rapping and make sure there's enough room for the rapper. Okay, let's. So I'm going to record this by hand. Record notes in automation. Go to options, typing keyboard to piano so you can play the notes. I'm using comma on my keyboard to play middle C. Two. Okay, so not a lot of kicks, very spaced. Hit Control Q to quantize. Let's do the same thing with the 808. Now this one, I know it kind of pitches down. I wish it didn't. But I'm going to play it. And hopefully, well, not hopefully, the notes aren't long enough for you to hear the pitch bend. Okay, it's 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, so you can't really tell. Now, if I hear it and it bothers me, I'll swap out the 808. It's a little hard to hear the 808 for some reason. See how it pitch bends? But when you slow it down, it doesn't pitch bend as fast. The kick and the 808 are clashing. Just trying to see how, let me see without. Trying to see how much the kick is distorting it. There we go. Oh, you know what? I forgot it's going through my analog chain. Let me turn it on. Okay, so now I'm running it through the analog chain. We can turn stuff down. We don't need to crank stuff. And you can see we don't need a lot of instruments. It's just the sonics are now introduced that makes this beat feel a lot bigger. Whereas when you're producing in the box, you keep adding stuff because you're trying to fill in and make it bigger. But in reality, if you had the right equipment, you wouldn't need all that stuff. Okay, so let's get these levels right. Open up the 808. See how the 808 was too loud going out? Making sure those kicks don't clip going out, because it's clipping on the bass. So now it's just a matter of picking up the energy, using those snare jumps. Okay, then you can have a section where it just breaks down into bass. So let's take out the 808 and the kick. Now I don't have, I'm trying to give you guys a sample so you don't need plugins. Let's open this up. Let's see how long this lasts. Okay, it lasts pretty long. Okay, because the reason, if that didn't last long enough, I would have to loop it, but we don't have to loop it. So let's just add this in, double click. So doom, boom. Let's pull it up an octave because I can't hear. So going from E to B, which is the fifth. Actually, let's repeat the E. Okay, let's just do a note at the end. We don't want it to. I'm going to double click, make this a slide note so it pitches up so it goes wing. Let's pull it back down, control down. So now we just need bars, really. We're not going to start off the song with the kick, so let's spread this out. Okay, we see how the sonics add a lot to it. Add a clipper to this kick so it's not clipping our chain. So the kick is clipping our chain. Also, we're clipping, what is this, coming back. Let's just turn down the volume going out. We could always make it louder with like a limiter. Just don't want to overly clip. And And you could halftime a certain section. So let's say, you know, you want to change it up, you could add gross beat. Might be a little too heavy. You could pitch it up and then run it through gross beat. But that's how you could create two different sections. You will get the project files. Just go to busyworksbeats.com/FL Studio. Let's run this from the top. Okay, so pretty open in the beginning, and then it's going to add the bass coming in. That's how you sample like Dragon 21 Savage. Go to busyworksbeats.com/FL Studio for the free project files. Thanks for watching. Subscribe if you're new. It's Game from busyworksbeats.com.